Hello everyone, if you are familiar with Vietnamese cuisine, you absolutely know the tasty and fluffy crispy bánh mì baguette. Today, I'm making a super small, super mini, very fun baguette, only 4 inches, that is 10 centimeters long. If you are interested to see how I make them, please come to the kitchen with me. You know, if you dip into the chocolate or the chili sauce is perfect. Welcome to Saigon Cook Travel. I am Saigon Cook. So I have here the active dry yeast. So I am bought this bag for a long time, and because I'm baking often, that's why I bought in bulk and big bag like that. But lately we were moved and I couldn't do back as much, so my yeast sit for a long time, so either throw it away or reuse it. So today I'm dry. Right now I have 3 tablespoons warm water with 1 tablespoon of sugar, and I will add here 1.5 teaspoon of yeast. Because my yeast is active dry yeast, so that's why I activate it. I bring it to life. So I will let it sit there for 5-10 minutes until it's have like a cloud on top of the bowl. Now that means the yeast are active, alive. Now, because it's a little long, so I also make a pre-mix yesterday, but we come back for that. So I use 300 gram of on-purpose flour. Because this time of COVID-19, I don't find a bread flour, so I use on purpose flour. To enhance it, I use an egg here. Here, this is the premix starter that I started yesterday with 3 teaspoon of warm water, 1 tablespoon of sugar, and 1 teaspoon of yeast, and 100 gram of flour and 50 gram of water. That's what I had in the bowl, that as you see. Now I use the stand mixer to mix my dough. Like I said, I will use 300 gram of on-purpose flour, 1.5 teaspoon of yeast, 1/2 of teaspoon salt, 1 tablespoon of butter, and 1 egg. The water I will use 60 cold water. The reason I use cold water because I want my yeast eat the flowers and bloomish before, you know, to be that way. I find that way my dough is better and the texture of the bread is better. So into the bowl of flour, I add yeast, salt, And butter, you can see the butter I took out from the freezer, so it was frozen, so I melted in a skillet with water. And this is the bone of pre-mixed starter from yesterday. The reason I use premix like that so that we have the better bread. Now I will beat the eggs a little bit. As you can see, I have a very good silicone spatula, and I use it to scrape the bone. It's a very effective tool. And now I beaten the eggs. You can just dump the egg into the bone and go ahead with the mixing. But I like to break it and mix it in advance like this to get a better mix for the flour before going to the machine. I will mix in the machine because I like the force of the Kitchen Aid mixer. But if you don't have the mixer, you can mix it by hand. And you mix and you let it rest. And I will show you how to test your dough and know when it's ready for proofing. I'm mixing the mixture in my bowl right now. I give it a little stock to help and to avoid the flour flushing on over the counter that way. I keep doing this, and I like to take opportunity to say thank you to stop by to watch my videos. If you are new to my channel, please subscribe. It will mean a lot to me. You are the reason I'm here. I have passion for food, cooking, baking, home improvement, gardening, everything. I like to share everything I know with you. So please come back and watch my video again, please. And like and share for everyone knows. So right now I use 50 grams of water that I measure, but I add the 10 gram more. That means 60 gram total. You don't take the measurement exactly. You need to feel the dough by yourself. If your dough is too wet, then you leave the water out. Don't add too much. When you test it, you add the water as you go. You don't make it too wet and you don't make it too dry, because too dry you will see the flour speckle out. And if you make it wet, it's very difficult to handle to shape the bread later. So I started at the speed 2, let it go mix for all together, And after that, I increase the speed into number 4. My KitchenAid mixer has many speed limits, so I choose to do the middle one like this. And in between, I stop and scrape down the bone, and it goes like 6-7 minutes, and I see my dough is mixing up, so I stop and I bring it into this glass bowl to proof. Again, I use this spatula to help me to get the dough out of the mixing bowl. You can see this tool is very effective, and you can see the bowl is clear and nothing left much there. Now, you can see the dough is very wet because I'm get used to it. I bake sourdough bread, so I'm familiar with the wet texture. But if you are new, you want to bake your bread, you make a little stiffer than me. And I just stretch my dough. When you stretch your dough, and it's like a membrane, very thin, shown through, but it doesn't break. That means your dough is ready. Now I use the little of oil to cover the top, and I try to flip it up, the bottom up, so that it goes into the proofing. As you can see, before I show you the water that I boil in the skillet. If you live in the hot place, then you can leave your dough on the counter to proof. But my house is a little cold, so I will put in the microwave, and I put the bone together with the boiling water bone in the microwave, and I let it proof for 75 minutes. And it's double in size. So if you see your dough double in size or more, 2.5 or 3, that's perfect. And the time is up to your house, your temperature. So I would like it expand more, but I think that I'm okay with like this, so I will start with my going with my dough right now. So I try to get the dough out of the bowl without leaving so much there, and first, I use the water to paint my granite surface, and I, with my wet hand, I bring on the side over and lift it up and put it back in the bowl, and you can see it's very sticky. If you use your bare hands without the water, it will be very difficult to handle, but with your wet hand you can do so. But if it's too difficult for you, you use some flowers. That will be okay. I let it rest for 5 minutes, and now I'm going to divide the dough and shape the dough into the bread right now. So with my measurement, and I will make only half of the dough for the small, super mini loaves. The rest I will make the bigger bread. So if you do like me, if you do the total measurement, then you will get about 28 super mini loaves, or I do only 14 small, and the rest I make 5 bigger loaves. Or if it's your choice, you can make it small, all of them. It will go fast, but because only me and my hubby, so we it's not much, so I make half of the recipe. So right now I stretch my dough into rectangular, and from the outside I bring the dough back to the center, and I do it again with my wet hand. The purpose of me doing that because I want to strengthen the strength of my dough. It's called stretching. Or if you bake your sourdough, you heard people say about lamination, that is there is to it. So at this point, after I'm stretching it, I will use the flour to help shape the dough, because if only without the flour, it's very hard to shape the dough. So like say I use half of the measurement, so I cut the dough into half now, and I will go on to weigh my dough. Each one, first I need to put the half of recipe away, cover it in cloth so the dough does not dry out. The rest I will divide into a small portion, and the portion is 10 gram. Can you imagine that? 20 gram. I will do 20 gram of the dough. Each loaves will weigh 10 gram, and I will make it into the length of 4 inches. Now my dough is covered with the flour, and it's easier to handle now. So So as you can see right now, I have 14 bones, small portion of dough, and I make it flatten them out, and from on every corner I bring back to the center. You can see it on my hand right there. You just grab the outside and bring it into the center, and use the flour to make it round. You can do this on the counter, but because it's too so small, so it's a fit on my hand. So I do my task on my hand. Okay, so let's go one more. You can see, flatten it out, and then from the outside, I bring it in to the center, and I binge them together, and after that, I use my two hands to shape it into round. After that, I use the cloth to cover and let it rest for few minutes, and I started to shape the my bread right now. So the first, you might that the first piece when you shape it round, that is the piece you started, you start first. So now I beat my dough one time, and I change to another direction and beat another time. I stretch my dough that way, and as a result, I will have one size smaller than in width in comparison with the other's end. And I roll the small end to the big end, and that's it. I have my first loaf. Now let's do another one. You see, I beat the dough onto my surface. It's about, you know, my two fingers and on my hands, and it's about like eight inches, about so. And I roll my dough, and on each roll, I binge my dough down. That way, my dough will keep the shape and stick together. It don't ravel. And at the end, because my dough very thin, they stick to each other, so I don't need to binge. But if you make sure that they stick together, you can binge the end together. And with my hands, I roll back and forth, and I use two hands at the two ends to make it taper at the end, and the bread look beautiful that way, like a professional baguette. You can see now I am shaped on my dough, and I have 14 of them. So if I did this for half recipe, if you want the whole recipe, you will have 28, and it depends on you divide your dough. So I cover and let it rest for 60 minutes. Now I sprinkle the water on my dough, and I will cut the dough. This purpose helping the shape of the bread when it's done. So I don't have my razor with me. I lost my razor, so I use my sharp knife, and this is the sharpest one I have, and I use the water to help it. The water cover sprinkle on the loaves, and the piece of paper there is a wet paper towel. If I saw it a little sticky, I use the paper to help it out. And that's it. I will sprinkle with the water again before I put them into the oven to bake. In the meantime, I already turned on my oven to 450 degrees Fahrenheit, and I boil some water so that the boiling water will go into that pan and go underneath inside the oven. And when I put my dough tray in, I will spray it. I'm spraying it now. The water in the pan, the water from my sprinkler, it will help the dough to rise. And I just back 5-6 minutes. At this point, you can pan your bread with butter and bake it for 1-2 minutes to make it glossy. But I am happy with what I get right now. So now I will break one to show you the crumb inside. It's a pretty acceptable. It's fluffy, and I will try one piece now. I have a spicy satay, soy chili sauce, and chocolate sauce, both one savory and one sweet. It tastes very good and very fun to eat. Please taste it with me. Thank you for watching. I hope I inspire you to do this for your family. Please let me know how it goes. Please like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Bye-bye.